Good morning, dear children. You all are welcome to the social class. In this class, we are going to see the fourth lesson in past and present. Topic of the lesson is Turkish invasion of India. Could you get any knowledge from this headline? Turkish invasion of India. That means the Turkish people, they are coming to India. The Turkish people invading to India. Here we can see the Turkish are mostly they are Arab people. They are the Islam people. Here you see the people. In the last lesson we have learned that Islam. No, the Arabs are Muslims. The India have the trading relation with Arabia, and the because of this trade, some the other countries have the knowledge, getting the knowledge about the fertility of India. So they are very interested to invade into India. The first person, the Muhammad Ghazni, he is very interested to invade into India, and he took so many steps. 13 steps he have taken. Finally, he is coming to India. After that, Muhammad Ghazni, the Muhammad of Ghori, is coming to India. You see that when that Muhammad Ghazni coming to India, he is coming in the year 1000, and he is belongs into year 1026. For 26 years he took the steps to come to India. He took for 17 times to come to India. And Muhammad invader, and he is a plunderer. He plundered our temples. And Al-Biruni received Muhammad's patronage, and he wrote some about that Muhammad in the Kitabul Hind. That is the finest work of the astronomy, mathematics, geography, and philosophy. That Firdausi, the author of Shahnama, was a poet in Mahmud's court. Firdausi was the author of Shahnama, and he was the poet in the Muhammad of Ghazni's court. Now we can see Muhammad of Ghori. In the year 1030, Muhammad of Ghazni was died, and Muhammad Ghori invaded into India, and he tried to occupy some places. Muhammad Ghori was an ambitious ruler, and he also wanted to expand his empire. He also decided to come to India because the India is a very fertile country, no? Not just for its wealth, and also build an empire. Ghazni came to India because to plunder the wealth of India. But Ghori came to India not only for the wealth of India. He decided to expand his place into India, built his empire. That Ghori is coming to India in the year 1175. And Muhammad Ghori conquered into Multan in the year 1175. And 1178, he received a temporary setback. Temporary setback when he was defeated by the ruler of Gujarat. He was defeated by the ruler of Gujarat in the year 1178. So he takes some rest, and he is planning, and he is again coming to India. In this time, he is facing in the year 1191 the Battle of Tarain in between the Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori. In this battle, Ghori was defeated by this Prithviraj Chauhan. But after this war, he going back. Muhammad Ghori, again he is taking rest, and he is planning, and again he is coming to the same battlefield. In this battlefield, Prithviraj Chauhan was defeated in the second battle of Tarain. But in the year Muhammad Ghori did not stop in this one. Then in this in this war that Prithviraj Chauhan was taken as a prisoner. But later, what he did, do you know? That Prithviraj Chauhan is coming as a slave to Gauri, but his eyes also was picked out by this Gauri. But he is taking the arrow and bow. He is defeating that Muhammad Gauri. Then why the small recaps we will take. Why did the Turks succeeded and the impact of the Turkish invasion in India? Turkish invaded only for the wealth and to build their empire in India. Ghazni came to occupy the wealth of India. He plundered some temples also we have learned. And Gauri is coming to not only for the wealth, and he is decided to build his empire in India. Then the impact of the Turkish invasion is very important. The Turkish invasion brought about significant changes in the political, military, economic and cultural life of India. The invasion paved the way for the establishment of the Delhi Sultanate. It controlled large parts of northern India. The rulers now maintained their own armies. These armies were trained in new techniques of warfare. Horses came to be used increasingly. Lahore and Multan emerged as new trading centers. The contact between the Turks and the Indians gave birth to a composite culture. This is witnessed in the art, architecture, food, language and music of that period. Dear children, read this lesson. After this video, we will get more knowledge. Thank you. God bless you all.